Okay, so we're gonna do a little video, show you all a little bit of video. I'm gonna show you all our supplies here right now. Paper towels for Mrs. The earthworms are in here. A nice good shot of the earthworms being earthwormy. We do cut them up for the smaller froglets. I rinse them in dechlorinated water, and then there's the holding cup. And the plate that is used exclusively for food items, earthworms, and any other food items that we might use for the frogs. Those are paper towels that come from this roll. We usually cut them up into proper sized strips to fold and put in the bottoms of the cups when we clean them. And we'll get this camera set up on a tripod so I can show you the process of us feeding the frogs. Okay, so the process of the froglets. I do my best not to touch the earthworms so much. Start over here. Real simple, just plug them out of the container, rinse them in the water, again dechlorinated. Put them in the holding cup. In a moment, we're going to cut them to size so that the froglets don't have such a hard time eating them. Because these tiny little froglets cannot eat a whole night crawler. There's no way. They're too large for that. The ones are. Okay, so my handy scissors, again dedicated only to doing this work, and my tongs. They get a little dirty from the earth that the earthworms are in. So what I usually do is I do a batch of pieces. I will cut the earthworms. Starting at the tail end, and yes, they squirt sometimes. I already am used to the size of the froglets that we're working with, so when I'm cutting the earthworms, I keep in mind that I have some froglets that are very, very small, and some that are a little larger, and so I cut varying sized pieces of the worm. And you vary it some because some of the worms are thicker than others. Some are really, really skinny. So just go by. Most of you only have one or two pets, and so you won't be doing this kind of a volume nightly like we do. But, so you get used to the size of worm pieces that your froglet will take. Now, we will offer them. Usually, we feed them one piece. If the froglet looks a little thin, we will usually feed it more than once, or at least offer it more than one piece. They don't always take it. Sometimes they're just fine and happy with their one piece of worm. Other times, they may eat three pieces. But we offer it, and we go by what they want. And you'll notice that a lot of the earthworms, they're going to exude a lot of the earth that they've been feeding on. It's called casting. That's what they call the soil that the earthworms come in their container. And it can get messy. Just looks kind of dirty to us, I'm sure. Some of the frogs don't mind it, others can't stand it. So I will usually rip the piece off if it's got an excess amount on it or too much slime. Sometimes they overdo that, and I'll just shake it in there and rinse it off. There's the process. and froglet. It's that easy. We have people sometimes that contact us and tell us that they're having trouble feeding a froglet. Won't eat for them. They don't understand what's going on. If they're stubborn and they don't want to eat, then you basically, like this one, will tease them. I will tease them until they finally open their mouth and take it. Once they get it in their mouth, they usually realize it's food. And they'll eat their piece of worm. Some of these little guys are really aggressive, and some are kind of shy. It just depends. Okay. But for the most part, there's really no reason that they should refuse food other than they're still full from the previous feeding. Now, if they are refusing food, chances are it's because something in the enclosure is off, whether it is their temperatures or their humidity, or possibly it's the space that they're in is too large. A large enclosure for a small frog can be very stressful and intimidating, so sometimes you have to cut that space down.
Yeah.
Okay, so these are the paper towels that we use for clean. This is a tub that we use for soaking them in between while their container is being cleaned. As you could see earlier, they were pretty dirty. There they are, and you go into the soaking tub. We don't worry about chytrid. They've all been either treated or we know that they are not, that we don't have any chytrid in our collection, because we address that very early on with our animals. The container gets cleaned, fresh little paper towel gets dampened, and there they are. The reason that we do this, instead of putting them on cocoa fiber, we are able in this manner to really monitor their output of waste. We get an idea if they are not pooping, then we know that there might be an issue with some compaction maybe. And so we keep an eye out for them. And as you can see, they're pretty active little guys. They do hop around a lot. They will jump out of a container given half a chance. And it's a long process because we have so many of them at any given time. But we've got it down pretty much to a science. And we keep them, the deli cups, stacks of them in larger tubs, and we go through one at a time. We will clean and feed and clean them, and then move on to the next large tub.
visualize your dream, record it in the present tense, put it into a permanent form. If you persist in your efforts, you can achieve dream control.
Walls you built within come tumbling down.